not have any evidence. You're just gathering it through subpoenas issued by this court. And I warn you that this is going to be a fatal error on your part.
May I be recognized, Your Honor?
Yes.
The witness now on the stand was not called by the prosecution precisely because the evidence she's going to present is the very same records that was presented already by the
bank. Yes, but you asked this court to subpoena her.
Yes, and therefore, Mr. President,
you should have manifested to the court that we want the subpoena to that witness quashed already.
Yeah, Mr. President, may I therefore make a formal manifestation that pursuant to the subpoena issued by the Honorable Tribunal, that we are adopting this witness as our own witness and we will conduct additional direct examination, Your Honor.
Okay. No,
but if Your Honor, please, may I be allowed even 1 minute only, Your Honor?
Yes, please.
They are now speaking of a subpoena requested by them. I hope I will be pardoned with using the word. That is a falsity, Your Honor. Because the very subpoena said, acting on the request for issuance of subpoena of Senator Judge Franklin M. Drilon. There is no mention about the prosecution, Your Honor. That's why I wanted to know, Your Honor, whether this whose witness is the witness on the stand. Because under our rules of evidence, it is very clear. The court shall not consider any evidence presented unless formally offered, Your Honor. And when we speak of documentary evidence, it must not be merely offered, but rather it must be identified, marked, and then offered in evidence.
Counsel, I have here a copy of the subpoena that I issued. I cannot remember the. I cannot see the date.
Maybe the first one, Your Honor.
Correct, but this is. I'm talking of this subpoena. I did not issue any other subpoena.
Yes, Your Honor.
Against this witness.
In that connection, Your Honor, may we ask permission to read the statement appearing here? Witness Honorable Juan Ponce Enrile, Senate President and presiding officer of the Senate, sitting as an impeachment court at City of Pasay this ninth day of the year of our Lord 2012, Your Honor. Then signed the Honorable Juan Ponce Enrile. So this is a February 9 subpoena, Your Honor.
Mr. President.
Well, I'm sorry, I forgot about this. Yes, I'll own this subpoena. Yes.
Mr. President.
Yes.
Mr. President, can I have the floor?
Yes.
Mr. President, the subpoena that the Senate President issued last is only in consistent with and in pursuit of the previous subpoena issued by the Senate President. This is a subpoena issued February 6, 2012, a resolution dated February 6 or February 7, 2012. I have here the unsigned copy, but the records the original is in the records of the Senate. It's a resolution, and let me read part of that resolution. Letter B, the branch manager and or authorized representative of the Philippine Savings Bank, Katipunan Branch, Katipunan Avenue, Loyola Heights, Quezon City, is commanded to bring before the Senate at 2 p.m. on February 8, 2012, the original and certified true copies of the account opening forms, documents for the following bank accounts allegedly in the name of Renato C. Corona. Now, during the last session of this court, we ask whether or not account number, whether or not the opening documents and the opening balances for account number 089-121-017-358 which was included in this resolution of February 6th, was complied with. And there was no compliance because the witness was under the impression that it was only the ending balance which was subpoenaed, when in fact the resolution of the Senate President clearly stated opening forms and documents. And since it was not this witness, it was not Mr. Garcia who had knowledge of this, this Katipunan branch manager was subpoenaed here, and that is clear on page 17 of the records of the previous hearing, and also on page 16, on page 17 and page 18. So it is very clear that the subpoena now issued again is in pursuance of the resolution of the Senate President dated February 6, 2012.
I would like to be heard, Your Honor, if I will not be ruled out of order, Your Honor.
Proceed.
Only in the subpoena being read by the Honorable Drilon, Your Honor, refers to appearance on the 8th. This subpoena refers, you are hereby commanded to appear before the Senate of the Philippines at 2 o'clock in the afternoon on the 13th day of February 2012. So this is later. This cannot be altered anymore. What I'm not after the testimony of this lady, Your Honor. I'm heavily thankful for her responding favorably to honor the subpoena of this honorable court. What puzzles me is this. Our rule of evidence states the court shall not consider any evidence not formally offered. Any lawyer of this impeachment court will agree with me that that is the rule. All right. Now, insofar as testimonial evidence is concerned, the offer is made the moment the witness is called to the stand. She is now called to the stand.
What is your pleasure?
My pleasure now, Your Honor, why I went to that extent of her testimony, therefore, should be stricken off from the record. She is not a witness for the prosecution, neither is she a witness for the defense, neither is she a witness for Senator Drilon.
May I be heard, Mr. President?
Yes, please.
Our earlier manifestation, Mr. President, is that we are adopting this witness as our witness pursuant to the subpoena, and a ruling was already made by the Senate President. We would like to proceed with this witness, Your Honor.
Okay.
Mr. President.
What is the pressure of the defense, Your defense?
Honor. Well, this will be a curative act, Your Honor, because the witness is true testifying already after the testimony, after
then
her testimony.
I order the stricken, the striking
Your Honor, please. May I be heard?
Testimony, just a minute. So that we can resolve this. Since nobody owned the testimony of this witness prior to your accepting him as a witness, I now grant the motion of the defense to strike out the testimony of the witness and order you to direct your question to the witness. It's ordered.
We reserve our right to appeal the ruling on the floor later on, Your Honor.
Yes.
Mr. President.
May I proceed, Your Honor?
Yes.
Mr. Witness, Your Honor, we are offering the testimony of Ms. Annabel Chongson to prove, Your Honor, and to identify documents that were subpoenaed by the Senate as sitting as impeachment tribunal. We will offer her testimony to identify the five accounts that were identified in the subpoena and ask her to identify the opening statements and the opening balances pertaining to these five accounts, Your Honor. And we will be presenting also related questions insofar as these are concerned.
Proceed.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Ms. Chongson.
Good afternoon, sir.
You are here pursuant to the subpoena of the Honorable Impeachment Court.
Very leading, Your Honor. witness is a very intelligent.
Let the witness answer.
Thank you, Mr. President. Ms. Witness, you are commanded by the subpoena to bring certain documents. Do you have the documents that you were asked to bring?
Beg, Your Honor.
Let her answer. She's an intelligent.
Certain documents. Go ahead. We submit.
Witness, did you bring the documents you were required to bring to this court by virtue of a subpoena issued by this court on February 6th?
Yes, Your Honor. I have with me the statement.
You have the documents?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, proceed.
May I approach the witness, Your Honor, to it?
One copy only.
Witness, Your Honor, presenting to counsel a bank certification from the PS Bank Katipunan dated February 10, 2012.
Your Honor, please, may we request that the document be, that we be allowed to examine the document first before any question is propounded.
The defense is allowed to
I understand that the copy is available.
Identify the account number to which that document is connected.
Ask the witness.
No. I'm just
returning. All right.
May I proceed and read into the records a description of the document, Mr. President?
We will object, Your Honor, because manifestation is no evidence
just
whatsoever.
Just ask the question. I link that document to any of the local currency account numbers stated in the subpoena. The contents are covered by the documents themselves.
Hello. Can you point to the bank certification, Ms. Chongson? The entry pertaining to account number 0891210173 58.
We admit that the witness can point, Your Honor.
Will you describe, Ms. Witness, the kind of account pertaining to this account number?
Then the best evidence will be the document itself, Your Honor, since it will be presented.
Let the witness answer.
Based on the document 0891210173 58, Your Honor, is a peso time deposit.
All right.
Thank you. Can you state for the record, if it appears in this document, when this account was opened?
Which account? Very big, Your Honor.
Your Honor, we were referring particularly to the first.